Hi everyone, my name is Vivek and welcome to my YouTube channel. This is the 8th episode about Vue Basics. If you are new to my channel, then please don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon so you never miss out my new tutorials. In the previous episode, we worked on computed properties and today we'll work on components. So, components are reusable blocks of code that are used to create modular and maintainable code base. Looking at our site, we already have one component, product.vue, which is imported in our app.vue. In the future, we might need two more components. One for this review form and another for making this tab. So now, let's create these components so that we can work on them in our next session. Open your text editor, and under this components folder, you can create a new file and call it product-review.vue. So first, let's create a template, and under S1 tag, I will just call it product-review. Then we need a script and the name of our component, which will be product review. Now we want to import this component under our product component. So at the very bottom, you can write the HTML tag followed by the kebab case. So it will be product review. So you can notice that once we write this HTML tag, it is automatically importing product review and it is also added in our components. So let's complete this one. Check the site and we can see our product review component. Now let's create one more component for our product tab. So open your text editor. And under this components folder, you can create a new file and call it product-tabs.vue. We need template. I will call it product-tabs. And then we need script. The name of our component will be product-tabs. To import this component in our product component, again we need the HTML tag followed by the kebab case. This time it will be product tabs. You can see product tabs has been imported and also added in our components. Now check the site and we can see our product tab component. Great. We won't be adding any content in our newly created component, but instead, by using props, we will add the shipping feature which will either show free or some cost. So what is props? Props is a custom attribute for passing data in our components. Let's work on props now so that it would be more clear for you. In our app.vue, let's add member in our data and you can set it to true. This means our user is a member. Now let's pass this data in our product component. So just after this name, you can add props. You can add your member inside the object. You can add type is boolean and then required is true. Now let's pass this prop as a custom attribute in our product component. So here you can add member and member. Now let's add shipping in our product component. So just after this variant, I want to create a new div with a class called shipping. I want to add a text called shipping and expression called shipping. Now let's create computed properties for this shipping. Here I want to add if this.member return free, otherwise return 299. Check the site now and we can see free over here. I think we have to remove this curly braces, so scroll to the top and remove one of them. It is fine now. So let's see what happens if our member is false. Now it should return 299 over here. Great. This is the end of this session. In the next session, we'll work on communicating events. Feel free to comment below if you have any question. Also, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to my channel to get more videos in the future. If you want some hosting companies, you can check the link in the description below. Thank you and see you soon.